हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। लेट्स कंटिन्यू दैट वी आर गोइंग टू अबाउट फिनिश इंटरव्यू टेक्निक्स फॉर मे बी इन टुडेज क्लास। कैन यू शेयर द स्क्रीन? Okay, fine. Now someone just reply me if my voice is audible to you clearly as well as the screen is visible. So is it audible and visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So in I think previous class people have done with this slide, that it says effective verbal communication is required, and in that it is English, and that English has to be again without mother tongue influence. There shouldn't be mother tongue influence, and whatever you people are speaking, that should be again natural delivery fluency. I think that in yesterday's class I have asked you people what problems you people face as far as English communication is concerned, and you people have told me that I think you're not able to make sentences, a little bit grammar and choice of words, and a fear of making mistakes. Those are some of the points that you people have discussed yesterday. So try to work on it. I will suggest here that you people can try to listen maximum English on YouTube. You people can follow certain maybe videos or channels that always maximize how to improve your English, or you can listen to English and try to speak it. Read something every day. Apart from that, if you're reading one book, let's say, or if you're reading one news, let's try to imagine that you're reading one news. So then try to tell that whatever the news that you have read, try to tell it in your own words. Okay, so whatever you have understood, you try to tell it to others. If there is no one to listen to you, in that case you can talk to yourself, or you can just stand up in front of mirror, and then you people can express whatever you have understood out of that news. Same you can do with, let's say, a movie that you watched. So you try to tell to your friends or to yourself or in front of mirror whatever you have understood from that movie. You just try to tell it into English, or it can be of a book. If you read a book, whatever you have understood of that book, you just try to tell it in English to yourself or to your friends. If there is any person who is listening to you, that is fine. You can talk to them. If there is no one, or if you feel that if I talk to somebody, they will laugh at you, then they will make fun of you. In that case, you can talk to yourself first of all, and then you can talk to someone else. But you need to talk. You need to think in English. That will help to improve your problems. Or what are the problems we people have discussed? We people can just overcome all those problems. Also, I told you that how pronunciation matters. If you're from same background, it is the matter of less worry. But if it is from cross-cultural communication, or you are from out of, let's say, your different backgrounds, cultural and educational, in that case your pronunciation is going to matter, and you need to be accurate in your pronunciation as well. And you can follow this tip that you can speak louder, or you can speak in low voice, so that other people will take a note of you and they'll listen to you. So that much more people have done so far. So let's continue. Let's go to the next slide and try to understand that why do candidates get rejected in an interview? Is there any reason? What might be the possibilities that any particular candidate gets rejected? That we people will try to understand, and we'll avoid it. Okay, all you people need to avoid those problems, mistakes that other candidates do that way people can avoid here. So first of all, it says if you're answering in a vague manner or if you're talking irrelevant, sure you'll be getting rejection. So let's try to understand what is meaning of vague. So do you know, anybody of you know what is meaning of vague? If you know, tell me. Does anyone know meaning of vague? Again, try to understand its pronunciation. You shouldn't call it vague. It is not vague. It is called vague. And that means something that is not clear or unclear. So let's imagine a situation where you're facing interview. Interviewer asked you a question and you're answering that question, but the answer you're giving, it is not clear. In that case, and it is happening for, let's say, 2 to 3 questions. If it is for one question, that's okay. They may consider that you are not getting the question. But second time, third time also, you are just giving such a vague answer which is not clear to them. In that case, it is sure that you are going to get rejected. And then next, if you're talking irrelevant. So what does it mean by talking irrelevant here? It means that not to the point. Okay. So whatever the answer you are giving, you're not coming to the point. You're talking, let's say, around the point, but not to the point. And in such case, your answer may not be exact and accurate. So therefore, again, if you're irrelevant for number of questions that you're answering, you're going to get rejected. So what you people can do here? What you people are expected to follow here? First of all, whatever you are going to say, it should be clear to you. First of all, it should be clear to you. And if it is clear to you, you need to make it clear to others. Those who are listening to you, you can make it clear to other people as well. Okay, so that care you people need to be taken when you're answering any question in the interview. You shouldn't use any complicated the sentences, words, which you are not clear yourself. And if you're clear, then you try to make it clear to for other as well. Then second, you just try to think about whatever you're talking, it should be to the point. It shouldn't be like that you are just talking relative or you're talking just related facts and figures and answers. That will not be to the point. But what question is, the answer should be related to that question only. You shouldn't talk much. Then next point we people will talk about, and this say that very fidgety. So what is meaning of fidgety? Fidgety means that very restless. You're not able to just concentrate on interview, but you're just thinking about the fears. Let's say that you're outside the waiting room, you're waiting outside the interview room, and then you're thinking, if now my turn is there, then what is going to happen? How am I going to answer all those questions? And then what happens? Your heartbeat gets increased, your pulse rate gets increased, and sometimes you feel sweating also all on your face. There is sweat, and maybe you're not able to perform well. And in that case, it shows that this nervous body language, that is fidgety. And when you are having fear, when you're afraid, so that time what is going to happen? There is little eye contact that you're going to maintain. Okay. So I think that I have explained it. When you just maintain eye contact, then what happens? And when you do not maintain eye contact, then what happens? So you people tell me. When you maintain eye contact, then what does it indicate? You people reply. When you maintain eye contact, so that time, what are the different signals which are conveyed when you maintain eye contact?
Confidence.
Yes, first of all, confidence. Then? Any other? Only confidence?
Attention towards
us. Yes, exactly. Attention, you're paying attention. Then? Very good. It shows that you are prepared. It shows that you're bold. It shows that you're talking truth. Okay. So these are meanings which are conveyed when you are maintaining eye contact. And now when you do not maintain eye contact, that time, what does it indicate? When you do not maintain eye contact, that time, if there is confidence, then there will be lack of confidence. Then it shows that you are not paying attention. Then it shows you're shy, nervous. Then it shows that you have confusion here. Not speaking truth. So you have to decide whether you are going to maintain eye contact or we are not going to maintain eye contact. That will be decided. Whether you wanted to give positive signals by maintaining eye contact or whether you want to show negative body language by not maintaining eye contact. Okay. So if you are not maintaining eye contact, then it will be considered that you are not confident, you are shy, you are nervous, you are having fear, you are not paying attention, you are confused, you are having fear, you are not talking truth. So all those meanings will be conveyed when you are maintaining less eye contact. So try to maintain eye contact. And how to maintain eye contact? I think that I've told you when you are speaker. So that time you are going to maintain eye contact with your listener. And when you will be in listener's role, so that time you are going to maintain eye contact with your speakers. Nervous mannerism. Okay, then try to pay attention to the next point. It says nervous mannerism. Okay, so what is this nervous mannerism? Nervous mannerism means that your body language shows that you're nervous. Like I just told you that from your face, maybe you're sweating, maybe your let's say facial expressions, or you're not maintaining eye contact. And because of there is a lot of fear, your heartbeats are increased. You wanted to run away from this place. And because of these things, you are just playing with your hair. So what are you doing? So maybe you are just catching this like this and you're just keeping your finger playing with your hair. Or sometimes other things that you people do, maybe there are other some things. Let's say you have pain in your hand or you're putting it on table. So you're playing with your pain. Or maybe in front of the interviewer, you are just biting your nails. Okay. So if you're doing these things, definitely it shows that you don't have manners and etiquettes. And of course, the conclusion will be that you will get rejected. Okay. So you people have to avoid those things, negative body language, then maintain eye contact and don't do any such things which will show your negative etiquettes and manners. Okay. So try to take care about these things in your behavior. Then we people will go for next point. It says lack of sincerity. So here also you people need to be very sincere. What do you mean by sincere? Being sincere when you people just in front of anybody, not only for interview but at any place, if you are just be polite. So if you're polite, then people will think to cooperate with you, to help you. Okay. And then you have to be again sincere. Sincere means that you're obeying rules, you're obeying instructions given to you, and you're using courteous language. So what is courteous language? Courteous language means that again in a soft voice you're talking. Soft means that in low tone you're talking. So that shows you're sincere, you're obedient, you're polite. And no employer would like to have any employee in his organization or in his company who is rude. Or maybe he is arrogant. Maybe he is, let's call it, not disciplined. So such candidates are going to get rejected. That shows you're not sincere. Okay. So maybe in voice you're talking high tone, that it won't be okay. So you people have to be careful about your behavior and your language and your attitude. You shouldn't show your attitude. negative attitude, okay, that will affect your interview, and sure you are going to get rejection here. Then next is utter superficial remarks to impress the interviewer. So what is the meaning of this? Utter superficial remarks means apparently you are showing that you have a lot of knowledge, okay, but actually you don't have any knowledge. So let's take example of this project work. So you're talking in a such a way that it seems that you have a lot of knowledge of the project, but actually you don't know the basic concepts of your projects. So in that case, you're just trying to make impression by talking big, and actually you don't know anything. So in such case, you have to avoid, you have to speak only those things that you know very well. Okay. So that will decide that you're just trying to impress the interviewer by talking anything that you don't know, that you don't have any idea. So that care you people can take about your selection, so that you're not going rejected by because of these things. Is it clear to you why candidates get rejected by the committees? Is it clear or any question? If there is, you just tell me. If not, then also reply so that we can go ahead. Nobody's replying. Are you feeling sleepy? Let me check people if they're online. Rather than I will take attendance right now. The calling roll numbers. So roll number one.
Present, sir.
Two.
Yes, sir.
Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Present, sir.
Five.
Present, sir.
Six. Roll number six, absent. Sampada, absent.
Yes, sir.
So why you are not answering so far? I'm just calling roll number six, roll number six, roll number six, and you're not just answering. Roll number seven.
Present, sir.
Eight. Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Present, sir.
11. 12.
Present, sir.
13.
Present, sir.
14. 15.
Yes, sir.
16. 17.
Present, sir.
18. 18. Absent. 19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22.
Present, sir.
23.
Present, sir.
24.
Yes, sir.
25.
Yes, sir.
26.
Yes, sir.
27.
Yes, sir.
28.
Yes, sir.
29. 30.
Yes, sir.
33.
Present, sir.
33, absent.
33, present, sir.
34.
Yes, sir.
35.
Present, sir.
36.
Present, sir.
37. Remember 37. Absent. 38.
Present, sir.
39.
Present, sir.
40.
Present, sir.
41.
Present, sir.
42. 43.
Present, sir.
44.
Present, sir.
45.
Present, sir.
46.
Present, sir.
47.
Present, sir.
48.
Present.
49.
Yes, sir.
50.
Present, sir.
51.
Present.
53
present sir
54
present sir
55
present sir
56
present sir
57
yes sir
58
yes sir
59
yes sir
60 61
yes sir
62 row number 62 is it audible 62 rohan 63
yes sir
64 65 roll number 65 66 67 68 so obscene numbers are like 8 14 16 18 29 30 31 33 37 42 52
hello sir 33 present hai
You are not answering. I just calling 33.
Hello, sir. Ah. Sir, 37 present. I could me.
What's name?
Pranoti Naik Nore.
Which lecture ka satin ka awaz aik yet nahi.
Arre, yachi problem hai sir.
Nahi, maza awaz aikal jat nahi ka tyancha awaz aikal yet nahi.
Tichu tumhala aikle na.
42 52 60 62 65 66 67 and 68 these are upset numbers so all you people be alert and pay attention so we'll go to the next slide I hope that you people are paying attention So here somewhat the people will see some of the do's. Do's means that some tips that you can follow that is called do's. So what you people can do as far as your interview is concerned, let's say maybe in next week is there or maybe after 4 days you people have interview. Okay, so within that 4 days, what you people can do, that you people will try to understand by these do's. So do take a practice run to the location where you are having the interview. Okay, so what do you mean by a practice run? That the place where your interview is held, you should go and check that place, how to go, when to go, and so different aspects you are going to check. Let's imagine that your interview is held in the metropolitan cities like Mumbai, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata, or maybe Pune or Bangalore. Such are the cities where you people are going to have your interviews. So let's say Pune, we'll consider Pune, and you're going to have interview in Pune. So you need to visit that place, let's say 1 day before. And 1 day before, you should check exact location, exact building or venue of your interview where it is held. So you need to check the what are the means of transportation available for there. Let's say there are auto rickshaws, buses, city buses, or let's say trains are available for that. Local trains are available for that. That you people need to check. Then also you need to consider what is the condition of traffic during your interview's time. Maybe if there is traffic, that you can consider extra time for leaving for your interview. And if you are not considering this, you may get stuck into traffic and you may get a delay to your interview less. So for this, you should have a practice run to your location that will help you to be there exactly on the day of interview. You'll reach on the time. You shouldn't reach there late. This I would like to tell you that people can follow this only if you're just trying for off campus. So what is meant by off campus? Off campus means that apart from your college campus, you are trying for other companies, that is called off campus. if you are going through your college placement activities, there is no need to have a practice run, because you know your college, you know how to go there, and you can reach there within time, a good time. So maximum students will get selected into college placement activities only. But anyhow, or unfortunately, if you did not get, then you can just think of off campus. And if you are going to have an interview off campus that time, you can just try this. What to try? That have a practice run. Reach one day before. Reach to the building or venue where your interview is held one day before to check how much, how long it is, how much time is required, and what are means of transportation available, and the conditions of traffic. All those things you people can check, so that you are not going to get delay or late for your interview. Okay, so that is one thing. Then next, you people can think of this. If presented with a job application, do fill it out neatly, completely, and accurately. So what is this now? So many of the times, companies, if it is applying again through college campus, you are not asked to write a job application later. But let's say there are some companies who have their own application form. What do they have? Their own application form. If they're giving you an application form, you need to fill it completely, accurately, and neatly. Many of the times what happens that we don't know how to fill it, or we don't know what to fill it. So in that case, you can ask if any instructor is there, if any faculties are there, or maybe any company person is there. You can ask them, sir, please, will you guide me what to write here in this column? And then that person will tell you. Okay, so people have to write down everything neatly. As far as it is going to be written manually, your handwriting must be good. It should be legible and it should be neat. You shouldn't write down shabby. Don't try to scratch whatever you have written. Don't try to use whitener, eraser, etc. Because whatever you are writing, first of all, go through the all form. What are the points? What are asking they fill? And once you're clear with all things, what to write, then you start writing. Then fill it completely. I just told you, if you don't know anything, what to fill in that particular column in the blank, in that case, you can try to ask the person who is there. And then whatever you're filling, you are going to fill it accurately. Another thing. So it should be correct. You shouldn't write something incorrect, and then you are scratching it, then you are rubbing it, then you are using whitener, then you are using eraser. Don't do it. Whatever you are filling, fill it accurately. So that thing you people have to take care while filling this application form. Then next, you people can think of this. Do bring extra resumes to the interview. So what is meaning of this? Bring extra resumes. Okay, so whatever the resume you people are going to have, usually in the recruitment process, you submit your resume, first of all, one copy to the recruiter or to the, let's say, employer. And based on your resume, if you're getting shortlisted, then you're called for interview. Let's call it personal interview. Okay. So at the time of interview, you shouldn't just go with empty hand without carrying any copy of resume. Rather than I will suggest here, you need to carry extra two copies. How many copies? Two copies of resume you need to carry with you when you are going to face personal interview. Okay, so suppose that luckily if you got selected and if they're asking you give your resumes, so in that case you shouldn't say, sir, we don't have a resume. I don't have a resume, sir, because I thought that I have submitted it and so it will not be required. So don't say something like this. Or you can say that, sir, I have not printed it out, so I will print it out tomorrow, something like this. So if it is required, you can present it, and you need to keep your resume in, let's say, two copies, hard copies, but in soft copy also, you can keep your resume on, let's say, your email ID, on your pen drive, in your laptop, or whatever the you people are carrying gadgets, in that you need to keep it. Same with for passport size photos also. If you get selected, they may ask you, give your passport size photos. So in that case also, you shouldn't just say, sir, I did not print passport size photos, sir, I will print it tomorrow. Or don't ask them, sir, may I use your printer or something like this. Okay. Or don't say that I haven't any passport size photographs. So you have to be ready with those things. And apart from that, again, many of the students, they are taking selfies as a passport size photos. You shouldn't be with a selfie passport size photos with having different poses and different backgrounds. Rather than, you need to shoot a passport size photo from a professional photographer and take its print out. And if it is asked at that time, you just present it. So just take care about this, bring extra copies of resumes as well as I suggest your passport size photos as well. Then next it says, do greet the interviewer. So that is only people have to greet the interviewer. So when you people enter into the interview room, so that time you people have to greet to the interviewer according to the day of the time, as per the day of the time. If it is morning, the people can say, good morning, sir, good morning, ma'am. If it's afternoon, you can say, good afternoon, sir, good afternoon, ma'am. You can say, good evening, sir, good evening, ma'am. Whatever, depending upon the situation, depending upon the time of the day, you are going to greet the interviewer. And this I will not recommend. Do shake hands. I will say don't. Why? Why? Because it is not okay. In corporate world, handshakes are common. Okay. You will see that people who are there, they will shake their hands. But see, if you're just first time, that time you don't extend your hand. If the interviewer is extending his hand for shaking, in that case, you extend your hand. Okay. So who has to first extend? Interviewer has to extend. In that case, you can extend your hand. You don't extend first your hand for shaking. And apart from this, nowadays, this because of this pandemic situation, it will not be okay because of this COVID-19. In fact, we are expected to maintain social distance. So therefore, there is no question of just shaking hands with someone. So with interviewer also, you are not going to shake hands. So I will not recommend this here. But in corporate world, you will come to know that handshakes are common and you people can shake hands with your co-workers, your seniors, juniors, etc. Again, there can be a problem if the candidate is male and interviewer is female. In that case, there will be a problem. Or there could be again problem if the candidate is female and interviewer is male. In that case also, it is going to matter just for first time. Okay, may not be comfortable. So if you're just shaking hand, if you're male candidate and you're shaking with interviewer who is female, it may not be comfortable for them. Or in other case, if the interviewer is male and candidate is female, it may not be comfortable for anyone of either. So in that case, you avoid shaking hand in such situations. But if you are at corporate world, if you are just having day-to-day colleagues and boss, in that case, you don't hesitate to shake your hands with them, okay? Then next is, do wait until you are offered a chair before sitting. So this is also an important scenario. Again, you can imagine a situation, you are knocking on the door and saying, may I come in, sir? So that time they say, please come in. So you're walking towards the interview table. And there one chair is kept in front of the table. And so you're not expected to go and immediately sit on the chair. So you are going there and standing in front of the table and greeting the interviewer so that they may just say you please have a seat or take your seat. Until and unless they're saying take a seat, you're not going to sit there. Okay. So take care about it. Because it will seem odd or arrogant. If you're just going and sitting directly, it will be not okay. So therefore, wait until they're offering you a seat like this. Please have a seat or take your seat, something like this. And when they're offering you a seat, again, thank you them because they're offering you a seat. So these do's, you people try to follow. So is it clear? Are you getting it? Understanding? Any difficulty? It is? Then ask me.
No, sir.
You're right. So I think that many people, they are connected, but they are not replying. Fine. So people will go to the next slide. And on next slide also, we people are having again do's that we people can have to follow. It says to make good eye contact with your interviewer. So why to make eye contact? I think that is first slide or in previous slide, I have told you that if you maintain eye contact, then what happens? And when you don't maintain eye contact, then what happens? So maintain eye contact, or I will say not only at the time of interview only, but in all communication situations too, whomever you are going to communicate. Let's say you're communicating with your family members. Maybe you're communicating with your friends. You're going to communicate with your neighbors, or you are in the market. You're communicating with anybody. So that time you people have to maintain eye contact. Maybe at workplace also, that you are going to maintain eye contact with the different roles. As I told you, if you're in speaker's role, maintain eye contact with your listener. And if you are in listener's role, you maintain eye contact with your speaker. So in this way, you are going to maintain a contact. As far as interview is concerned, there you have to make, but in other situations also, I will recommend that you have to maintain eye contact. Then next point, it says to show enthusiasm in the position and the company. What is meaning of show enthusiasm? It means that, ah yes, usaha, apan usaha hi asle paise ki va ata ha job majhyasathi cha ahe ani mi jar ite selected jalo tar I will be very happy. That has to be seen from your face, from your body language. You should be feeling enthusiastic and energetic, full of cheerfulness. You're wearing a wide smile on your face. If you're carrying it, that shows your enthusiasm. How you can show enthusiasm? Enthusiasm is not a kind of object that you can show. Let's say I can show that this is pen and I can show it. So you cannot show enthusiasm like this. So enthusiasm will be seen, will be observed through your behavior, through your talking, how excited you are, how eager you are, how enthusiastic you are, how energetic you are, and that all your behavior will show that you are enthusiastic. Because here you're getting some kind of job post position responsibility as far as you are going to work with some of the company. And so therefore you need to show that you really need this job. You are expecting that you should get this job. So this kind of behavior and attitude should be seen through your behavior. Then next to be people will think about this. Do make sure that your good points come across to the interviewer in a factual, sincere manner. So while answering to the interviewer, any questions which they are asking, while answering questions, you have to answer in such a way that it shows that what are the good points you have, you're bringing in focus. You are just paying attention to them and the interviewer will ask you more about your good points soon. So you're going to bring it in your interview, in your answer. And that again, in a factual, sincere manner. Factual, sincere manner means with the flow of. It shouldn't be that interviewer will realize that you are just trying to pay attention on your achievements and on your good points. So with the flow of interaction, with the flow of question answer session, you're bringing one after another, your talents, your skills, and your good points, your achievements in between. In your answers, so try to do these things. And again, next point, it says do stress your achievements. So do stress your achievements means that whatever you have achieved so far, let's say it may be academic, it may be any extracurricular activities, co-curricular activities, it may be any competition that you have won, it may be any project that you have done. There could be number of achievements that you people are getting throughout your 4 years. Okay, and try to just work on those 4 years that you're getting maximum achievements. So try to participate into different competitions, try to maximize your participation, then try to do some short-term courses or try to get different certificates. So these will be your achievements. So therefore you can stress it, you can focus, emphasize on your achievements when you people will be answering in an interview. Okay, then we'll go to the next slide. And on next slide, you people are getting now some don'ts. Don'ts mean that the things that you have to avoid, that you have to unfollow. So which things you shouldn't do? To avoid controversial topics. What is this controversial topics? The topics which can create, let's say, fight, quarrels, or two different opinions. You can take an example of maybe religious views. So maybe there are some people who are extremely about Hinduism, Muslim, Christian, or any other religion. They're just becoming. So you shouldn't just support that only this particular of one particular religion, and you shouldn't criticize other religion. So these are controversial topics, and it shows your views So therefore, avoid such controversial topics. If it is in your interview, so in that you people can just try to be moderate. Moderate means that don't try to criticize other people's opinion or their religion or their cultural or any other aspects. But you can just be moderate in such things. Avoid controversial topics. Don't ever lie. This is already I have discussed that if you don't answer, you are going to accept it, admit it, sir, I really don't know answer of this question. I will try to find more information about this question or answer. I will try to find out it later on. Okay. Answer questions truthfully, frankly, and succinctly. So whatever you know, you just tell it truthfully, frankly, without any pressure, without any kind of suppression. And succinctly means in short, to the point. Briefly, you need to answer. You shouldn't make it too much lengthy. If there is one question and you are answering this question for 5 minutes, that will not be okay. So in short, you are going to answer to the point. Exactly. All the necessary information that you are going to give through your answer. So that way, you people are going to answer it. That is succinctly. Succinctly means short but to the point. Then next is, don't say anything negative about former colleagues, supervisors, or employers. So what is the reason you shouldn't talk anything negative about your former colleagues, supervisors, employers? Tell me, why you shouldn't talk negative? Imagine that you're working in an organization and now you're leaving that company. And in such situation, you shouldn't talk negative about that company. Why?
It shows irrespectness.
Turn a little bit louder. I couldn't hear your voice.
It shows irrespectness.
Yes, it shows disrespect. You're right. If now you are here and you're talking negative about your previous organization, tomorrow you are going to leave this organization and you're going to join some other. So when you're going to join some other organization, that time you're going to talk negative about this organization as well. And they have nothing to do with your who was your previous colleague, who was your supervisor, who was your employer. They just wanted to know your thinking process. They just wanted to know your attitude, how you're thinking about this. So therefore, they wanted to just ask this question. Okay. So therefore, don't talk negative. As far as you people are concerned, you're fresher. So you don't have any colleague or you don't have any supervisor or you don't have any employer. But they may ask you about your college. So don't talk anything negative about college. Sir, college was so strict, sir, that they were asking us come to the college every day. They are just charging a lot of fines, sir. They are just making uniform compulsory, sir. And our college was not so good, sir. Something like that. You don't talk negative about college, principal, campus, or any of the authority who was related to the college. Okay. So don't talk negative because it shows your attitude and your thinking process. So you can avoid these things. And the next question is that don't answer questions with simple yes or no. Okay. Explain whenever possible. So in such case, it shows that if any question is asked to you, question may be verbal question may be yes no question, but there you need to add one or two sentences. Suppose like this, you are just asked this question. Do you use social media? So for answering this question, in fact, question is a verbal question. And its answer can be yes or can be no, but you shouldn't say yes or no only. How you can say? You can say, do you use social media? Yes. Yes, sir, I use social media because I think that using social media is advantageous for getting connected with the people. We can stay in touch with each other and we can share good ideas. So therefore, I use social media. So this can be your answer. Or you can say another way also, no, sir, I don't use social media because I think that using social media can waste our productive time and maybe we feel frustrated when we people just spend a lot of time on the internet and on social media, and then we realize it. So this way you people can answer, but don't just only say yes, don't say only no. You just try to explain it at least in one sentence itself, okay? Then next, describe those things about yourself that showcase your talents, skills, and determination. So already I have told you about this, that whenever you are just answering, you need to focus on your talent. Whatever you know, whatever you are good, you try to bring it into focus. Whatever skills you people have, try to discuss about it. And what are your determinations? Try to work on it. Try to talk about it whenever you people are just answering any question. So that time. And also give examples as well. Only saying that I have this skill or I have this talent, it is not sufficient. So let's take an example of leadership quality. So when you're saying I have leadership quality, that time it is not okay to say I have leadership quality. You need to support by giving some examples. So you can give examples. So when I was in my school, I used to be the captain of my kabaddi team, or various activities I used to just organize things, or at our department we have this event, and I was the main coordinator who just completed this event. Or you can give another examples also, which will prove that you really have that, you have taken leadership and you have done something by taking responsibility. So that will show that you have leadership quality. But just saying I have leadership quality, it will not show that really I have leadership qualities. Okay. So that you people can follow in don'ts. So for today, that much is. We'll stop here. In next lecture, I think we need to discuss frequently asked questions. So in next class, we'll talk about FAQs. And then we will finish this unit. So we are going to stop here. You people can join next class. If any questions are there, you can ask me. Is there any question, difficulty, or that you would like to ask me? I expect an Arjun Shankar problem, difficulty. If no, then should I end this meeting from my side? Because already we people have taken attendance. So absent numbers already we have discussed. Reply something yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I will end this meeting from my side.